Welcome to the fourth part of YPanel add-on video series. On this video, I will show you the back tools. Here are the hot links to quickly jump to the part you want to watch. To back using back tools, make sure your model has a material and unwrap PV. There are few back options, and each of them has its own settings. Let's check them one by one. For backing AO, make sure you choose the correct back option and just click back. Wait a little bit. The result will appear on the UV window. And it's also added to the material as a pen slot. If you can't really see the AO result on the viewport, you can always turn on the shadeless option. Please be aware that baking process can take quite some time, so Blender will freeze until baking is finished. It can range between few seconds to few minutes depending on your CPU. For the settings, the first two are suffix and blend. Suffix followed by material name will be the name of bake image result. For example, the last bake AO is named Suzanne_AO because the material name is Suzanne and the suffix is _AO. Blend is for choosing the color blend for the texture result. For the AO, the default is multiply. The rest are ambient occlusion settings you usually found on the scene properties. Back normal can take data from three sources. I'll skip the last one to the end of this video. Let's try to add bump paint slot and do some painting. You can convert this bump map to normal map by simply using back normal. Now a paint slot containing normal map appear in the list. It produces same effect as the bump map. This can be really useful because some game engine doesn't have support for bump map. Let's add multi-res modifier and subdivide it 4 times. Back normal will back high subdivision value of the multi-res modifier to the subdivision base which you can set here. For example, let's try to sculpt some mustache. Okay, that's enough. Now let's try to bake it. Now that the baking process is finished, the mustache you see here is coming from the normal map. And if you notice, the multi-res subdivision also changed its value to 1. That's because after baking, the multi-res subdivision will automatically lower to the subdivision base value you set before. So you can immediately see the normal map in action. Next is Dirty Vertex Color. Let's just try it. Okay, the base is finished. Maybe you can't really see the result. If I turn on RGB to intensity, as you can see, the sharper shape like mustache has more highlight. It can produce nice worn out effect like you can see here. Next is backlight. Let's go ahead and try it. It's for baking light shading to your model by default. Now the shading comes from the texture. If I move the light source, the lighting still stays. Backlights also has more features. If you choose Hemi or Sunlight as the type, you can quickly back as if the scene has only one light. You can also set its direction. The last two options are to bake diffuse and specular color of your material. I'm using my character model for this demo. You can see the shirt has many pencils, some for diffuse, some for specular, and some are both. If I bake the diffuse color, now all the diffuse color are baked into just a single separate pencil. This can be quite helpful to quickly merge all your diffuse textures. Bake specular color is more like the same, but it's for the specular color. Now if I want to, I can safely remove all the diffuse and specular color pencils. Next, I will explain about BakeTools global settings. First option is AA or anti-aliasing. It can be used to remove jagged edge of your bake result, which is common things if you ever bake using Blender. For example, just take a look at the bake-like result. If I zoom in, you can see this line is like a bunch of stair steps. If I bake again using AA, notice that now the line is smoother. It's using super sample technique, so beware. The bake time will greatly increase if you increase the sample. Width and height will be the size of the baked image. And the margin will be the distance between UV island and the baked color edge. Next, if you use override matching suffix, the bake result will override a variable image with the matching suffix I have explained before. So if you disable this, the bake result will always be created as a new pencil. All selected objects option is for baking more than one object or materials all at once. Let's try it by adding another object. Now select both objects and you can bake them together in just one click. The last option is for baking from another high resolution mesh. To explain this option, I'm using different scene. This scene has two versions of meshes. On the layer 1, you get low poly meshes which don't use any subdivision modifier at all. If you look at the info window, this layer has around 11,000 trees. On the other hand, on layer 2, you get high poly meshes. These meshes are sculpted and using multi-res modifier with high subdivision level. You can see it almost reached 3 million trees. Basically, if you check use high poly meshes, it means the baking process will use high poly mesh data to low poly mesh. You will also see three other more options. The first one is prefix. This one is to indicate which one is the high poly version of the lower poly mesh. The default prefix is HP dash. For example, I have already set this prefix naming. I have this low poly shirt on the layer 1 which name shirt, and the high poly version of the shirt on the layer 2 which name HP-shirt. Let's just try to bake to normals. You just need to click on the low poly mesh and click bake normal. Here's the result. You can see now the low poly mesh takes a lot of detail from the high poly mesh. Another example, high polymesis of this pants actually have many parts like belt loops, and the pants itself. But if you look at the low poly pants, it uses only one mesh. If I back to normal, you can see the result still took the details from all the high poly parts. All the belt and the loop details are back into the normal map. That's because all these high poly objects names still have the prefix and the low poly name. For example, the belt is named hp-pants.belt. And the loop is hp-pants.loop. I tried my best to explain this add-on, but if I missed something or if I wasn't clear enough, feel free to leave a comment down below. Also, if you find any bugs or have any suggestions, you can go to the GitHub page and report them. While this add-on is free, it took me quite a long time to develop. So if you find this add-on useful, please consider supporting me on Patreon. That's it for this video. I hope you can have fun with this add-on. My name is Yukup, and see you next time.